Greetings, my name is Rob McCoy of RAM Communications, and today we are going to continue our Telecom 101 series with an installment on SD Internet. SD Internet, like SD-WAN, is software defined, and we're using a minimum of two internet providers. And like SD-WAN, we have a lot of benefit in terms of failover, load balancing, BGP. What's different about SD Internet? Well, that's what we're going to dive into here. So, here we go. SD, or Software Defined Internet, provides your business customized control over the bandwidth, so you can allocate it for different functions and for disaster recovery. You'll notice in the illustration, we have two internet providers. You have a cable provider and you have a T1 provider. It's also important to note that in this example, the service is handling internet for a single physical location, whereas with SD-WAN, we're providing network and internet policies for several locations at one time. SD Internet, like SD-WAN, is using what we call an active-active setup. What it means is that both internet providers are bonded together and used at the same time on the SD device, which is usually a firewall. It could be a router as well. They're both bonded together and we're utilizing both connections at the same time. With proper execution, your SD service provider is going to use the SD Internet firewall to assign specific functions for each ISP, assign specific priority levels to each application or function, and install instructions for failover or load balancing between the two ISPs. With ISP1, which is our cable example, we're assigning video, hosted applications, any real-time applications to that provider, because in this case, we are assuming we have more bandwidth available, and those applications need more bandwidth in order to work properly. In ISP2's case, which is, we're saying, is a T1, we are assigning voice, email, instant messaging to that service. And we're doing that because that service normally is more reliable than your cable provider might be. And also, we know that typically, in a single office environment, you don't need nearly as much bandwidth for those applications to work properly. What makes SD Internet a compelling solution? Let's look at how we recover voice. There are several reasons all businesses should consider SD or software defined internet. In this example, SD Internet provides you more control and uptime, and therefore productivity, than we could provide you with older technologies. Uptime's the first key to productivity. After all, if you don't have any internet service available, your staff's probably not doing much. In this example, the software-defined service is used to create a smarter and more reliable disaster recovery solution. The secret behind this solution is combining both internet providers into one pipe. This means that there's always bandwidth available for all applications, not just our voice example. So let's take a look at that pipe for a second. What the pipe is demonstrating is a combination of both internet services into one. What's great about that is not only do I have more bandwidth, but I have bandwidth available at all times, assuming I have at least one internet provider available. Let's look at our voice example. If the primary voice bandwidth is not available, then the SD firewall device detects the problem in milliseconds. Voice calls are now using the cable internet portion primarily and providing bandwidth to complete all the calls. Once the primary internet service for the voice, the T1, is restored, then the normal path is restored for voice service and there is no interruption. Here's another compelling reason for using SD Internet. Let's look at data recovery. In the second example we're showing you, the same software-defined service is handling disaster recovery in the same manner that we illustrated for voice. Since the SD firewall device is combining both ISPs into one pipe, the T1 service in our example is providing bandwidth for data-related applications. If the primary data bandwidth is not available, the SD firewall device detects the problem, again, in milliseconds. Now, your video and your other applications that were using cable are now depending on and using the T1 portion, which is providing the bandwidth the end users need to continue using those applications. Once the cable internet provider is back online, the normal path is restored without any interruption for the video and the other hosted applications. What also makes SD Internet a compelling solution is the ability to prioritize bandwidth for your most important applications. In this example, we know video is the top priority for the office. The SD Internet is used to prioritize most of the bandwidth for the video application. Bandwidth can also be allocated accordingly to the second and third most important applications. Without this capability, you would have very little, if any, control over how your bandwidth resources are being used. Final reason, I think maybe the most compelling reason to use SD Internet, and that is, with all the technical wonders, this is an affordable solution. SD Internet is game-changing because it's allowing small and mid-sized businesses the tools that are necessary to provide the productivity and disaster recovery features that, until now, were cost prohibitive for most organizations. So that's it for this installment on SD Internet. And if you have any questions, or if you're looking for more information on SD Internet or any of the other topics that we've covered, we specifically encourage you to check out our SD-WAN video resources on our YouTube page. Give us a call or visit us anytime at our YouTube page or at our website. Thanks, and have a great day.